sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, constantly talk about hadhim al-ladhat, the destroyer of desires. The destroyer of desires, they said, O Messenger of Allah, and what is the destroyer of desires? What's this thing that you call as the destroyer of desires that you recommend us that we constantly remember? So he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Al-Mawt, death. Death is the destroyer of desires. Death is what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam refers to as the destroyer of desires. And why does the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam refer to death as the destroyer of desires? Because the moment that you remember death and the moment that you know you are dying, especially when you know that your death is near, you no longer desire anything of this dunya. So indeed does destroy your desires. That moment that you know you are dying soon, you no longer have this desire to collect more money. You no longer have this desire to build more houses. You no longer have this desire to have fame and power. You no longer have this desire to increase from your wealth. That moment that you know you are dying soon, you no longer have this desire to desire anything. And that's why sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called it the destroyer of desires, hadhim al-ladhat. Hadhim al-ladhat. But the amazing thing is, my brothers in Islam, we all know that we are going to die. And we all know that we don't know when we're going to die. Every single one of us knows that death is near. And when we say near, it does not mean that death is today or tomorrow. But whenever death is always near. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, كُلُّ نَفْسٍ دَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Every single soul shall taste death. Every person shall taste death. Every person shall experience death. Every creation shall experience death. And the only one that lives and never dies is the one that created life and death, and that's Allah Azza wa Jal. Every single one of us knows they're gonna die. And this is a reality that no one can escape from. This is a fact that no one can escape from or run away from. But the amazing thing is, we live as we're gonna live forever. We live as we're never gonna die. We live as we're never gonna stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We live as we're never gonna go into that grave. We live as we're never gonna be prayed on. We live as we're never gonna be asked a question by Allah. This is the reality of our lives. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is the most honorable creation to Allah, the greatest creation to Allah, the best creation to Allah, إِنَّكَ مَيِّتٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتٌ. Verily, O Muhammad, you shall die and everyone else shall die. Yes, you shall die, O Muhammad. You shall die, O Muhammad, even though you are the most honorable creation to Allah. Even though you are the greatest creation to Allah, you shall die, O Muhammad, and everyone else shall die. And yes, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did die. If death was to be taken away from anyone, or anyone to be abstained away from death, it would be Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But yet, Allah made Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taste death, and everyone should taste death.